Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to AWF Glory Days 3 Preshow. I'm Philip Ontario, and I'm joined by
Christian Edwards, the voice of FSW, but that's not important here. Welcome to AWF Glory Days 3, the Preshow.
Oh man, ladies and gentlemen, we're finally here. We're in Hollywood. We're in Los Angeles. We're going to start things off tonight with a number one contenders match for the tag team titles, AAA, the American Patriots.
Oh man, both of these teams have just been at each other's throat as late in AWF, and we also have this match between Jack Maximus and, speaking of AAA, Alberto Jr.
Oh man, these guys have been wanting to go at it. This is going to be one great match. And speaking of great matches, we got the Junior Heavyweight Championship match, Travis Sparks, Ryan Dublin. Travis Sparks claimed to have a big history as Ryan Dublin. We're going to see if this big pass has any effect.
Travis Sparks is a nice guy.
A nice guy? Are you kidding me?
He's a fucking gentleman.
A gentleman.
These men, however, are dicks.
I can't disagree with you there.
I mean, look at this. Fucking Ireland with his pedo stash and Stephen Smith looking like Superman.
Well, AAA, you know, they've been on a bit of a slump as of late, but tonight they have a huge opportunity to turn everything around.
Oh yeah, especially if they win this match, you get to easily squash the Maverick Brothers.
That's if the Maverick Brothers are still tag team champions after Glory Days, because remember, they will be fighting the Disciples.
Oh shit, I forgot about that. Well, these guys are boned. That's why, you know what, I don't even want these two guys to win. Fuck them, man. America's a great country, man. You know, cheeseburgers and baseball and the Olympics and America and these two guys. Fucking Anderson Johnson and Andrew Justice. Team USA, the American Patriots.
Yes, American Woo! Patriots loved very much here.
Oh, yeah. Wow, it's like everywhere, the crowd is like erupting right now, and this is not even the main show. This is the opening match.
This is great. This crowd is jam-packed. They're ready. We got more in store, guys.
Oh yeah, there's more when this came from. You know, it's a 3-day. I think it's a 3-day event, if I'm correct, or a 5-day event. I've just lost track of time because of all the excitement. I can barely sleep, so I'm losing track of time. Woo! Bell rings.
Bell. Here we go.
And let's see what goes on here. There's a front headlock. And I don't want to do your job. You do your job, Philip, well, goddammit.
There's a hip toss by Ireland.
Yeah, Ireland is... If anything, I can give Ireland Stephen Smith. Both of them are hard-hitting brawlers as of the very technical and flashy American Patriots. In Ireland, all he cares about is, you know, what his country's best for, known for. Fighting.
Exactly. Ireland has that Irish pride. But he's going up against a team that's all about American pride right here.
And the very traditional American wrestling, and that elbow drop right to the spinal column of Ireland ain't going to do him no favors in becoming number one contenders. How are they meet?
You know, I've heard some interviews from AAA, Stephen Smith, in Ireland, and they said they're very offended that a team like the American Patriots gets an opportunity like this just because they're American. They feel that is why they formed AAA.
Well, the real reason why they're not number one contenders is because they're bitches. They whine, they complain. And Stephen Smith breaks up the pinfall.
Stephen Smith, look at this.
Oh, well, what's he doing? Hey, he is not the legal guy,
He's
you know.
Justice in the ring.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah, sorry. That's what I thought. Do your fucking job.
Okay. Got Ireland. Oh my God! What a thunderous shot right there! What is he doing?
Ireland. Those are not fists on his hands. Those are freaking war clubs.
Ireland, one of the most impressive brawlers in the AWF. Ever since really joining AAA, he's become so vicious and becoming much more of a brawler. And Stephen Smith.
Oh my God!
That guy's been a brawler for years.
Stephen Smith is a 6'5", 270-pound man. He's just all meat. I've actually looked this up. Stephen Smith is about 4% body fat.
Only 4%.
Yeah.
He takes a huge honor in that.
He takes, oh my God, he's like Mr. Spectacular of England. You know. And that Russian leg sweep just shows him how internationally, his international background when it comes to wrestling is a very seasoned veteran. Hip tosses, once again, hip tosses Andrew Justice into the ring. Why?
I have no idea. It looks like these team, I don't know if it's just, they just want to fight or what.
Well, you should be more focused on the man in the ring who was getting beaten up behind the ref's back by Ireland. It's like, come on, man. Why do you do this? That's right, hip toss him. Hip toss his British ass back in the ring, you know. You know.
Yeah. Wait, what is Stephen Smith doing here?
Oh, shit. Stephen Smith. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
He's rushing to Johnson's head.
Oh, my God. Best suplex ever.
Well, obviously, Stephen Smith agrees with that.
Stephen Smith he deserves the taunt, but you know what? He's just a dick. It may sound hypocritical, but he's a dick.
He is a bit of a dick.
Yes, he can be. And he tags in the biggest dick, and that's Ireland. You know, the biggest dick with the smallest dick. That's why they call it an Irish curse. Wink, wink, Seamus.
Oh, my God.
Front headlock there by Mr. Anderson Johnson, the forearm right to the throat. Reminds me of Lex Luger. Another American.
Look at that impressive
American fist drop. A very American fist drop.
Very. Wait, why am I raking the eyes? Come on, referee.
Communist eye rake. That's what a Nazi pile driver. Scoop slam. Oh my God. Sorry, I don't want to break cough, Abe.
Oh my God.
Throws Anderson Johnson over the top rope. Oh shit, not on a suplex. Oh my God. That is like the best suplex I've seen in the last 5 minutes. No lie.
No lie?
No lie.
Ireland's on the top rope is very rare for him, and Johnson...
They're too fucking fat! That's right, suplex his ass. Show him where we're from! America! Yeah!
Johnson, what's he gonna do here? He's gotta go tag in his tag team partner here.
Yeah, he looks kind of worn out, but you know what? I think he's going to use that advantage and throw Ireland's Irish greasy ass into the corner. Tags in the captain of the American Patriots, I like to call him. Anderson, I got a mustache. Andrew Justice, you know.
He's grown out a brand new mustache.
You know, that mustache is giving him powers, man. Look at Cody Rhodes.
That's true.
It's a nice mustache.
A belly-to-belly suplex.
What an American belly-to-belly.
He's going for the end here.
Oh, God, we could have new number one contenders for the AWF Tag Team Championship. The American Slam!
Down he goes. Oh, wait. Johnson, he's getting there. Just to make sure Stephen Smith doesn't get interfere. There's a three!
You failed! Fail! Fail! Ha!
Stephen Smith was too late. He could not break up the pin.
You know, that's what he gets. He went after the wrong person. And once again, the American Patriots proved that America wins. Fuck everybody else. Yeah, and look at that. You know, Stephen Smith, so exasperated, he's so pissed he failed and he just fainted. America.
American Patriots have picked up a huge win here. They're going to be challenging the winner of the Mavericks and Disciples match. We will see the winner of that later on tonight. So we got number one contenders here, and we're just getting started.
Here we go, Anaconda Vice locked in. Anaconda Vice and Shawn Walsh is tapping. Lou Boo has retained the All-Stars Championship against Shawn Walsh.
This is not happening.
And Edge Young attacking Lou Boo.
No. No. No, he's signaling for the end here. No, not Redemption Road!
Damn it! I can't believe it! AJ Young, who won on night one, won that damn contract, has cashed in, and now he's called All-Stars Champion.
CJ Hawkins will challenge AJ Young for the Call All-Stars Championship at Call All-Stars 6.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. We're here live in Los Angeles, California.
I mean, look at this. Look at Jack Maximus trying to get the approval here of the fans here.
Well, he's representing his home country of Puerto Rico.
Yeah, he's got kind of a long way away from home right now, and he's trying to get the approval of these fans. This is good. He's trying to show that he's not like those damn AAA commies. And speaking of which, he's going to whoop the leader's ass tonight, Alberto Jr.
Well, if you remember a few months back when Maximus came into the AWF, you know, AAA was very impressed with his work. In fact, Alberto Jr. himself would come out during some of his matches and give him the approval. These guys started teaming up, and it looked like Maximus was going to join AAA. But, you know, one match they didn't do all so well, and Alberto Jr. just called Ramirez Sanchez to go beat him up.
Well, speaking of Ramirez Sanchez, there's that 7-foot monster right there. He's so unstoppable. And one thing I gotta agree with you, Jack Maximus is a very impressive competitor here in the AWF. He's a very bright up-and-comer, and he knows he shouldn't waste that by joining AAA. And Alberto Jr. is now becoming, instead of an angry leader that got rejected, he's acting more like the freaky girl that asked you out, and now he's all jealous and wants to kill you. And gets her ugly sister, Ramirez Sanchez, please don't eat me, to attack you. I just turned this into a ghetto fight. One of them is going to be Sharkeesha.
I don't think anyone wants to be Sharkeesha.
No.
But, you know, Alberto Jr., no matter what you say about Alberto Jr., he may not have the most wins in the history of the AWF, but he has Ramirez Sanchez.
Yeah, he has Ramirez Sanchez. And look at that, Ramirez Sanchez. Oh, my God, just DDTs him right in front of Ramirez Sanchez. That's just a spit in the face, sir. And he...
Oh, my God, he just took out the referee.
So many fails. Jesus, fuck. Come on, guys. What are
wait,
you doing?
Wait, what's
that? Oh, wow! Ramirez Sanchez!
He just got ejected!
Holy shit!
This match is not even a minute in, and Ramirez Sanchez, the muscle of AAA, is out of here!
Yeah, not even our camera knows what to do! What the fuck's going on? Oh, there he goes. Jesus, already Ramirez Sanchez has already been ejected, and now Jack Maximus now has an infuriated Alberto Jr. to deal with.
Oh man, this is great, ladies and gentlemen. Now we know we're gonna have a fair match right here.
Yeah, fair match between these two right here. Alberto Jr. stomping away at the arm of Jack Maximus. Missed that dropkick there. Jack Maximus, like I say, he's a very good all-rounder. He's a very high-flying wrestler. I'd like to see him succeed in the junior heavyweight division if that wasn't occupied by two crazies going after each other.
Two crazies?
Hey, Ryan, that was just as nuts as Travis Sparks, sir.
What? How is that?
He's freakishly huge, and he threw Travis in a trash can.
Oh, my. That did not happen. Travis Sparks is crazy. He just assuming things.
Hey, Travis Sparks is nice with me, man. He buys me tea.
Buys you tea?
Yes.
Well, that's very nice of him.
Yes, he is. Anyway, Alberto Jr., who's really developed, and just think about it, a year ago, Alberto Jr., around this exact time, Alberto Jr. was in the Money in the Bank ladder match.
He was in the Money in the Bank ladder match, and he very rarely did he win.
Yeah, he's a former Cruiserweight champion, which is now the Internet Championship. But really, Alberto Jr. was having the worst luck, and then all of a sudden AAA was formed, and look at him now, he's really honed his craft.
He really has. Alberto Jr., he's been very impressive in this last year in the AWF. He's done a lot of big things. Now, granted, sometimes he's had to do some cheap things to get it done, but can't take away that he's accomplished some good big things here in AWF.
Hey, yes, and look at Jack Maximus. Oh my God!
That was an innovative move, and he's got the cover. Hey. Is this gonna get it?
He drove his foot right in Alberto Jr.'s nose. Could have broke his nose. Could have, you know, knocked him out. Look, lariat right in the corner, knocking the wind out of Alberto Jr., and a very Puerto Rican uppercut.
Yes, and what's the Puerto Rican gonna do here? Oh my god.
Oh my god, welcome to fucking San Juan, bitch.
Double foot stomp.
Ooh. I like this Jack Maximus. He's vicious.
He's very vicious, and he loves to fly around the ring, and wait, but, oh, Alberto Jr. caught him.
What I like about Alberto Jr. is not only does he have that high-flying ability, but he's also a very great mat wrestler. He is very technical for his size. He can take on big people like Brock Manson and put up a good fight against them.
Yes, he can.
You know, but the only thing I don't like, I mean, Alberto Jr., great wrestler. He's just a fucking asshole. Bam!
What a nice kick there. And yeah, he is an asshole. Whenever he wants things to get done, he just lays Ramirez Sanchez on people. But
he plays the race card too much, man. He's like that friend that wants to get all the benefits because he's black. Or Mexican.
Pretty much.
Mostly Mexican. Oh, shit, oh. What the fuck? He landed perfectly on his feet there. The athleticism is not going to pay him off. He just got a knife-edge chop. And now Jack Maximus has all the control. He is going to fuck this guy up now. Flying forearm. Into a Manhattan drop, into a scoop slam.
Uh-oh, Maximus, he's heading up to the top rope. What's he looking to do here? There's an elbow drop.
Elbow drop right to the heart of that communistic Mexican. And now he's going to send his ass over the border.
Hey, what is this? Oh my god!
Oh, shit!
This is a new move here.
Man, neck breaker. 2, 3.
Jack Maximus has picked up a win. He's defeated Alberto Jr.
Holy shit.
I love this. He's very happy about that.
Wow, Jack Maximus celebrating. I've never seen him celebrate before. That's pretty cool. Jack Maximus, very excited about his victory over Alberto Jr.
Just like everyone here in Los Angeles, in the Staples Center, very happy that Jack Maximus picked up a win over Alberto Jr. Wait, look, Ramirez Sanchez, he's back out here.
And he does not look pretty, he looks pretty disappointed, and so is Alberto. Alberto is furious.
Wait a minute, he's blaming Ramirez Sanchez for this.
But Ramirez got ejected like a minute into the match.
But he wasn't here for the rest of the match. How can you just blame Ramirez Sanchez for that? Ramirez Sanchez, he can't believe it. Alberto Jr. is very pissed off.
Yeah, well, he's pretty upset, and you see.
Wait, what's with him? Oh my god, the fans are erupting here!
Ramirez Sanchez has just told Alberto Jr. to take your job and shove it.
My god, ladies and gentlemen, what a moment here. Alberto Jr. can't believe it. Ramirez Sanchez, he's gone from Alberto Jr.
Awful waffle. Fuck you.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the main event of the pre-show here. We got Travis Sparks, who even has a shirt that's talking about how nice of a guy he is.
He's a nice guy!
We'll see if he's nice enough that he'll be able to walk out here with the junior heavyweight.
He's showing everybody that he's going to beat Ryan Dublin in 4 minutes. He's showing everybody that he can count to four. He's showing you guys nicely how to count to four.
Nice. How nice is this?
It's like the I'm watching you thing, but he's doing it at a person with glasses.
Oh.
Look at that, man. He's being so nice to the fans. He's letting them get up those pictures of him. You know, Travis Sparks is a fucking gentleman. He doesn't need a bow tie. He's at that level of manliness.
Gentlemen. Travis Sparks is a guy who is just
look at this hulking giant of a fucking roid freak. This man is not a junior heavyweight.
He is 239 pounds. He just reaches the...
239 pounds of what? Barry Bonds juice? What the fuck?
Very passionate about his weightlifting.
You know, he's a bully. Nothing but a bully. He's just jealous. He's jealous of Travis Sparks' success. He's jealous because he couldn't capture shit when he first came in the AWF. Travis Sparks was born with a silver spoon in his mouth. Ryan Dublin was born with his dad's dick in his mouth.
No, you know, how dare you call Ryan Dublin a bully? Ryan Dublin's not a bully. As Dublin pointed out a few weeks back, there's no way he would have even known Travis Sparks. They grew up in two completely different states, but Travis Sparks claims that Ryan Dublin stole Travis Sparks' girlfriend, his prom date, and threw him into a trash can.
Yeah, it threw him into a trash can. Look at the fucking size difference between these two hulking giants. This man's tall enough. He's the same height as Brock Manson. He's got to be. He's got to be the same height as Texas Black.
Oh, he's not that tall.
This man looks like Jack Swagger.
My God.
Jesus, what a dropkick there by Travis. Travis Sparks wants to hold his ground. He ain't a pussy. He's not Sean Walsh. He's not going to back down when someone uglier gets up to him.
Sean Walsh doesn't back down. He's going to be fighting his Uncle Shane in the main event.
And he's going to get beat up by an old man.
Oh, is he?
Yes. Knowing Sean Walsh, he'll get someone to do his dirty work because he's a bitch.
I'm pretty sure Sean Walsh won't need that. I'm pretty sure he'll have no problem defeating Uncle Shane here tonight.
Well, you know. Oh my God, look at the height on that moonsault. Whoa, Travis! Yeah! Show this little Sandy the lesson.
Little Sandy. That's another thing. He's called these little Sandys.
More like rather large Sandy.
Rather large Sandy.
Yes. Look at this. He's Andre the Giant clubbing him. What the fuck, man? Jesus. Oh my God. He's going to break a vertebrae. Travis needs that back for supporting people like you, you fucking big freak.
You know, let's not forget, Travis Sparks is the one who issued this challenge. He wanted this match.
Well, Travis Sparks, you know, he's like David, and this guy's more like fucking Two Goliaths.
Two Goliaths.
Yes, this is Ryan Goliath. What a fucking Goliath spine buster. Oh my God, what a leg. He can break it. He can knock him out of a tree with that foot.
Knock him out of a tree. I don't see any trees around here.
You know, go outside. Oh my God, that sidewalk slam broke the sidewalk.
It's only a two count.
Because Travis Sparks is as tough as nails, but Ryan Dublin eats nails for breakfast. Fuck. Call the match, goddammit.
There's a spine buster by Ryan Dublin.
Spine buster.
Oh, wait, what is Dublin doing here? Oh my God, the Tiger Bomb here. One, two.
Travis Sparks invented that move.
He invented that move.
Oh my God, not anymore, he has a caved in chest.
You know, Travis Sparks signed up for this. He's the one who wanted this match.
Boy, he's gonna win, too. Don't worry about it.
He's not winning right now.
Eating him up. Ryan Dublin just needs to stop being a dick and give Travis his turn, like, right here.
Give him his turn.
Yeah, it's his turn.
Don't take turns.
Well, Travis has to take a timeout soon enough anyway, so, you know, he's only got so much time. That's right. Give him a fucking moonsault. Yeah. Show him who you're from.
Who you...
Yes. He's from God.
He's from God.
Yes. Travis Sparks is Jesus Christ incarnate.
Well, Jesus Christ is getting his head slammed into the mat then.
Because Ryan Dublin's the devil.
He's the devil.
Yes. Holy shit.
Another vicious spine buster there.
He's spine bustering his soul to hell. Oh my God! He just told him Satan!
He told him Satan?
Yes! Oh man, I love fucking with you. It's great. You're just like Socko. BAM!
Well,
you know. Oh no! Oh no! He's gonna spin him into another dimension! What the fuck?!
Wait! Oh my God!
Is that legal?
Well, it's pretty legal. The referee isn't calling for the bell and Travis Sparks is...
No!
Thank you. Only two.
Thank you, based God. Oh, shit. No, Ryan Dublin, don't do this. Don't do this. Stop. Nope. What did he ever do to you? Travis Sparks is a nice person.
What did he do to him? He made up a story to make Ryan Dublin look like a big bully.
Ryan Dublin is a big bully. Emphasis on big. He's fucking enormous. He looks like the Titanic. Fuck King Kong.
Jesus. And wait, look at this. Oh, so the suplex.
You're so surprised. He did that move 2 minutes ago. Burial. Scott Adams taught me how to bury.
Huh?
Yes.
Impressive.
Very impressive.
Why
aren't you wearing an orange do-rag? Are you a wigger, sir? You're from Minnesota. You're not Irish.
He is Irish. His parents were born in Ireland.
Well, he looks like a wigger. He looks like Brandon Ross on cocaine.
Oh, no. Don't insult him like that. Boy.
Careful, Travis. We all believe in you. We all believe in you.
Oh, man. And wait. Travis Sparks got suplexed from the top rope.
It was an unsafe suplex. You could have broke his neck. You don't know what you're doing. I'm going to get Vince Russo to swerve you.
Oh, my. Wait.
No! No!
It looks like
no.
He's going for it again.
No. No, 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 no! Travis.
Out.
Travis.
Dublin's on the top rope. What is he doing?
No!
You're
going to kill a man! Thank you, Travis. Oh my god. Travis is, you see, he's got that John Cena mentality. He's gonna win. Look at that moonsault.
Is that the leg hooked? One, two.
Shit. Travis got this in the bag. I don't need to worry about this anymore. You don't need to worry about it. You know.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Oh my god.
Ooch. That's what he gets for throwing him in the trash can.
Throwing him in.
Yeah, he's gonna show off a little Sandy's here tonight who he is. He is gonna give you all the awful waffle, because he hates awful waffles. Oh shit!
Sparks now is a springboard body splash!
He's not giving a shit anymore, he just wants to body splash him.
Oh.
Oh, he kicked him in the balls! Yes! Oh my gosh, Shiny Sage!
And Ryan Dublin, he's down and out. Travis probably should have went for the cover there.
Oh no, I know what he's gonna go for. He's gonna kick him in the face! Boom! Travis Sparks just very methodical with his moves. Oh god, Ryan Dublin's back up. Oh no! Fail.
A miscalculation there by the junior heavyweight champion.
Oh no, Ryan, don't do this. You're better than this, Ryan. You big fun. You're not even a cruiserweight. You're not even a junior heavyweight. Look at that! You're showing me, you fucking asshole! Sir, you know what I'm saying!
Wait, oh, he's gonna go for the cyclone, wait, no!
Oh, yes! Yes! Travis Sparks has got this in the bag! He's gonna fucking kill you!
Oh my god, he got him!
Sniper shot.
And it looks like Ryan Dublin's out. Travis Sparks is beating people with a super kick and, one, two, three!
Hey! Yes! Yes! The nice guy always wins!
The nice guy
wins. Yes, he wins. He is the nice guy. Travis Sparks showing that jabroni, that little Sandy, that big bully, that he can overcome the odds if they just believe in him, in his hustle, loyalty, and respect, and integrity, and intelligence, and intensity. You are awful waffle, sir.
Regardless, Travis Sparks has retained.
Travis Sparks is the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we still have the main show, Glory Days 3. We still got a hell of a lot more matches for you guys to see, including the United States Championship match between Taikyu and AJ Bronze.
Yeah, it's going to be student versus master. And will the torch be passed, or will the teacher always prevail over the pupil? And then we have this match. 6 men, 1 briefcase, Money in the Bank ladder match. The returning El Martino, Chris Korn, Bond Dynamite, Big Dwayne, last year's winner, Russ Taylor, and Europe.
Can't wait to see who's going to walk out of some Money in the Bank. Also, can't wait to see who will be the tag team champions for the American Patriots. Will it be the Mavericks or the Disciples? This is
My money's on the Disciples, but you never know, the Mavericks are known to shock AWF every single time they get into a ring. I still don't like them. And then we got this match, no disqualifications, to a hatred that's been brewing ever since the beginning. Brock Manson, the Sandman, takes on Dynamite of the Kings of Kong. It's ACCD versus AWF Part 1.
Oh yeah, I can't wait for this brawl to happen. I can't wait to see this. JMI puts his internet championship on the line against Tank.
And despite what the belt tells you, JMI is the internet champion. That might change because I see Tank coming back and whipping JMI's lily livered ass. And then we got an I Quit match between Chris Hartford, the brother of Ben Hitman, and AJ Young, the Claw All-Stars champion. Who's going to make who quit in this AWF versus ACCE match part 3?
Money's on Hartford. We got First Blood, Christopher Wonder, CJ Hawkins, AWF versus ACCE, and it's gonna get intense, folks.
Oh yeah. Christopher Wonder says he wants to make CJ Hawkins bleed to death. He wants him gone, and then Wonder wants to go after the AWF championship, but this is what I'm worried about. The streak. Can Mike Ryder keep his streak alive against two vicious monsters who have teamed up in the past before? That being Texas Black and Tattoo Chaser.
The streak has never been more threatened. Can Mike Ryder keep his streak intact?
They say it's what you make, I say it's up to fate.
Oh man, I can't wait for this one. Hell in a Cell, King versus King. Evan Rockville goes one-on-one with Danny Hardy.
Danny Hardy and Evan Rockwell, another case of student versus master. So this one is for the control of the Kings of Claw and possibly the demise of them. Then we have the ACCE Championship match where Ice Cream Fest decided to get the World Wonder Woman of Fred Thompson and the Nancy Fifth Wrestler of Robot Pinky, the newly turned coach of ACCE, Ben Hitman.
We got the AWF Championship match, father versus brother, Tyler Riley versus Sean Riley. Which brother will be the champion?
Yeah, all of that and more. There's going to be tons of action come Royd H3 with this epic main event right here. Walsh, it's Sean, it's Shane. It's for the control of AWF and ACCE winner take all.
Which one will be our boss after?